This is Lynn Voigt from WisconsinGarden.net. This is part 3 of my latest video. Enjoy! Okay, just to give you an idea of how many tomatoes I used, this was filled to the over brim of tomatoes 3 times. So 3 of these bowls full of whole tomatoes, which we have now reduced down to 1 pot of sauce. It's still cooking. I'm adding the spices. We've added more garlic and more oregano and more onion powder. And now we've just added some garlic powder just to give it a little more kick. But now I have to add some more because we put it on. We keep taste testing it so that we don't overdo. I haven't gone overboard with the salt because you can add salt later. I'd rather have less salt than more. So just to give you an idea of how many tomatoes it's taken just to get that much. But if you have a lot of tomatoes and you don't want them to go to waste and you've canned enough or you don't like stewed tomatoes, this is another option. You could also use it, I suppose, as a drink. I mean, you could can it and use it either as a very rich tomato juice, or you could, if you're of this spirit, you could use it as a Bloody Mary mix. Put in a little celery. There you have it.
Well, just think of all the other veggies you could add to it.
Sure, you could add
zucchini,
green pepper.
Peppers.
You could add green peppers and, like I said, celery. If you like to add real onion in there, that would be good. I'm making this the way my family likes to eat their spaghetti sauce, so I'm limiting my palate a little bit because they tell me I have a winning spaghetti sauce. I don't know. It's good to us. It's very tasty. Now this has been cooking approximately 4 hours. And I was afraid maybe we were adding too much salt, so when we combined them, I did not add salt. Now I know when I put them in the quart jars, I will be adding 1 teaspoon of salt on the top of each one. But other than that, it tastes pretty good. Okay, here we go. Now I've washed and sterilized these jars, and I have them sitting here on the rack that the water has been heating up a little bit just to take the chill off of them. Then I'm going to set them here and scoop it in. This is called hot packing because it's already starting out hot, as opposed to when in a previous video we did cold packing tomatoes where we just put them in room temperature. And since I don't know how many quarts I'm going to have, I just have everything ready for whatever I'm going to need. Now on the top of this, I will put 1 teaspoon of salt, and I'm leaving a good half inch breathing room, maybe even more, but that's okay. I'd rather have a little more than a little less. Okay, then my salt goes in. 1 teaspoon. Wipe off the top just in case I dribbled. I have my lids sitting in hot water so that the rubber gets soft and acceptable. Cover. And it's just like every other canning episode that I've done. Screw it on, not too tight, not loose. There we go. 1 done. And it's the same for each one. I'll do it. Quite gonna make it. Which means we'll have to try this one sometime this week. I just add water to this one. Okay, so that's our batch. So we ended up with 5 full quarts and almost a 6th quart. I think I'll move these around. Now these have to boil. Once they come to a full boil, they have to boil for 40 minutes. So put the cover on. And this is called a steamer canning pan. And I'll know when it's boiling because the steam will shoot out about 6 inches. And that's when I start timing. So this takes a while for it to get up to that temperature. Even though it's hot, sauce going in, oh, it can take half an hour sometimes. But that's cold pack. I've never actually done a hot pack, so it might not take quite as long to get up to speed. So we'll just keep an eye on it. Bye for now. Very pretty. Okay, now when you move these, you don't want to jiggle them around too much. You just want to gently take them and put them on a cloth to cool off. And hopefully they will start pinging and let you know they're done. We go. Now I'm going to close the store because I do not want a draft on them, and it's cooler outside. So now they sit, and as they cool off, you hear a pop. That means they're sealed. You don't hear a pop, and the cover does not go in, then it's not sealed. Then you just keep it in the refrigerator until you're ready to use it, and you can leave it in there for about a week or so. But hopefully these will all seal. That is 30 pounds of tomatoes. But it's very concentrated.
Oh, 6 tomatoes a jar, approximately.
Mm-hmm. 6 pounds of tomatoes.
6 pounds,
yeah. Sure looks pretty. So it's been a busy day, and we ended up with 5 quarts of tomato sauce, and looking forward to using it and seeing how well we did. As far as hot pack versus cold packing vegetables before you put them in the canning pot, it did make a difference. It was steaming, within 5-10 minutes. It was that fast. So it was nice and quick, and I could start timing after that. So, if you have a recipe that you would use, that you use for sauce or tomato juice, please send me an email, lynn@wisconsingarden.net. Thanks for watching my 3-part video, and hope you enjoyed it. Thanks again. Bye-bye.